Good morning, respected mentors, my dear friends, and everyone present here. We are the team members of Virtual Chemistry Lab. We are going to present Virtual Chemistry Lab, mentored by Avinash sir and Rajnikant sir. Now I'm going to introduce my team members. He is Siddharth, myself Supratap, and Pratik, who is not there because he went for the IPC camps. Now in today's presentation, first we are going to cover the objective of our project, then we are going to cover demo of our project, and then we will go through what learnings we have made while completing this project and challenges faced while doing this project. And finally, we will conclude with the results and conclusion and future scope. The main objective of our virtual chemistry lab is to bring chemistry lab to our PCs and implement chemistry lab experiments in a more efficient manner using 3D lab equipments and 3D animations. And we implemented CBSC lab experiments and provided functionality like for teachers like viewing, performing and for setting an experiment and evaluating the what the student has done while performing an experiment. We have provided functionality for a student for performing an experiment and viewing demo for the what student can do before performing an experiment. Now Siddharth is going to show the project demo.
Hi, I am Siddharth Charya and I will be showing you demonstration of our project VCL. So I am logged in two accounts. One is mine and in incognito I have logged in with my co-intern account. And the main functionality we have is we have implemented CBSC class 11th and 12th experiments. So let me perform an experiment to show the capabilities of VCL. I will choose the easy one. So this is the initial setup which I get. I have a pH meter. I have two beakers. I have two chemicals, on which one is unknown HCl solution and one is 0.1 molar NaOH solution. And I have a burette. So my aim is to determine the concentration of 20 ml HCl solution with titrating it against 0.1 molar NaOH solution. So in this VCL lab, we have implemented all the general equipments available out here, and most of the chemicals we have implemented most of the chemicals. And so let me start with this experiment to show how to perform. So we can place a funnel in the burette, and like a titration experiment, one is of unknown concentration and the other has a 0.1 molar concentration which we know, and so the known solution we pour it into the burette. So we have implemented these animations, and let me take the unknown solution and pour it in a beaker. So we have also implemented the pipette. So in real chemistry lab, what we do is we take 20 ml or some water solution, and then some volume of a solution which we don't know the concentration of, and we are required to find that. So the pipette volume can be seen above. So I will select approximately 20. So and this is a 20 ml solution of HCl which I don't know what the concentration is, and I am pouring it in a beaker to find out the concentration by titrating it against the NaOH. So I can see the initial pH of 0.7, and this I can place it on the burette stand and I can start my experiment by, so the pH is changing as I am pouring on the NaOH solution. So I want the point where the pH changes drastically. So let me pour it out, and so it's near about 10. So I've used 40 ml of NaOH solution, and I know the concentration of NaOH was 0.1. So for a student he can easily identify what was the concentration of the HCl solution which was given. We can directly use the formula M1 is equal to M2 V2, and so the VCL can implement all these general chemistry lab experiments. And if I save it, then then for the then we are creating a journal of the experiment we are performing, and the teacher can evaluate what I did. So let me go to home and then go into the my Cointern account and let me refresh it. And
as I have set up experiment for the other students, so I can view from my account by clicking on the evaluate experiment link, that I can see that who has performed the experiment which I have set up. I can see that two users have performed. One is Sid, which he has performed recently, and other user is Equinox. Now I can see the how he has conducted the experiment by clicking on the view conduct button. I can see that first he is bringing the bottles on the table, and then he is filling the burette with the known 0.1 molar NaOH solution. I can see that he is pouring in the beaker. Then I can see that he is sucking the chemical from the beaker to the pipette, and pipette volume is rising and beaker volume is decreasing. Now I can see that he sucked 20 ml, which is required for finding this HCl unknown concentration, and he is pouring into another beaker for titration. He has seen the pH first, that what is pH initially, and he started pouring from the burette till he get a end point where pH changes suddenly, and he stopped the pouring action from the burette.
So through this experiment, through this project, it can be implemented in a real school, like a teacher can set up experiments and the student can perform it, and then teacher can evaluate it, teacher can see what the student did, and then teacher, we also have implemented the setup functionality. If the teacher want to edit any experiment, he can just edit that, or he can create as many experiment as he want. And for the student purpose, we have also implemented demonstration mode. So if a teacher set up an experiment and perform it, then it is basically created as a demo for the students, and the students can view demonstration. So this project can be used for the test purpose also, and also for learning of students. So the teacher can create demos of experiment, and then student can view it whenever he or she is free and learn something. And for the test purpose, I have shown how it can be implemented. Now I would show some more advanced features of VCL. Let me choose any experiment. So this was an experiment. So I will show you some advanced features of VCL. Firstly, there is a dynamic table addition. So we can implement as many tables as we want. If a teacher want to set up hundreds of table, he can just click on add table, and then as many table as he want can be set up. So this VCL can be further used in a much broader way than what we have implemented. And we have save and restore option also. So if it's not a test, then what the student can do is he can perform half an experiment in one go, and then he can, if he don't have time, he can save at the current position, and then log in again, and then resume that experiment. And implemented most of the equipments. So let me show you some. So this is a weighing machine, and let me choose a chemical. So if I choose HCl in its solid form, if I want a label, I can add it, but that's optional. So this is where I get the HCl solution. I haven't added a label, so it's not coming here. So what I did was I take 20 gram of it, so it can be viewed here. So this VCL can be extended to whatever use we want. We can perform experiments like creating a solution of 20 gram, some HCl compound with some other liquid or some other compound. And we have also implemented equipments like Bunsen burner, and we have test tubes, we have test tube stand. So for salt analysis purposes, what we do is generally we don't waste chemicals and we take a test tube to check which group it belongs to. There's also experiment which we have set up with this concept, and so most of the experiments can be done by VCL, and we have also implemented the wash functionality. If a student has used some beaker and if he want to wash it, so we have also implemented the wash functionality. And Burette I have shown you in the previous example, pH meter I have shown you, and these are some of the things which we have implemented. And also we have undo functionality in which I can undo my moves. So if I undo my move, so the last move will be undoed. So this chemical I washed and it has come again. So if a student by mistake has done something wrong, he can undo it. So this was all about the experiment. Then I will continue with my presentation. About the learnings part, as I was already from software quota, so I already knew 3js, so doing this project was a very hard job, and I have to learn advanced concepts of 3js, and I have lots of knowledge of it. And about the backend part, we learned about JSP servlets, MySQL, Ajax, and being a small team, at present I know all of these technologies. And for the documentation part, we learn LaTeX, and the main thing anyone learns in an internship is about software development and teamwork, which we also learn. And about the challenges faced, these are some of the challenges which we have listed, but according to my view, they are really less. The project was really much more complicated. The undo functionality, the functionality of adding dynamic tables, as many tables, either it's 1,000 or 1,000, everything was a tough job for us. And implementation of animations in it, sucking pouring actions, and other things were also some of the challenges we faced. And now I will let my friend Shiv to continue with the rest of the presentation.
Finally, I am going to conclude our today's presentation with results and conclusion and future scope. We have implemented CBSE 11th and 12th chemistry lab experiments and provided a more interactive way of learning by using 3D equipments and 3D animations. Our future scope can be more equipments, chemicals and reactions can be added to expand the virtual chemistry lab, and also it may be possible to implement real-time virtual chemistry lab, as we have seen that dynamic tables can be added, so teacher can see multiple students performing the experiment simultaneously and grade them accordingly if he wants, and this can be all thing on the real basis. Thank you all, and we hope that you have liked this our project.
So the animations that you have created, they're using what software?
3js. It's a JavaScript 3D library.
Okay. So there is a library which permits you to quickly assemble things together.
No, it's a poorly documented library, and most of the time we have to ask answers on Stack Overflow or search or experiment on our own.
How about using tools like Blender to create these animations?
Blender is just to create an objects, and animations we have to write JS code for that. So in Blender we can create objects, but ultimately we have to write code for how the animation are working. But we, instead of Blender, we use 3js only to create objects, because it provides more functionality.
You have documented all the animations that you have created.
Yeah.
Is there a documentation which suggests how you start creating an animation using 3DJS? Because of the poor documentation that you have, what I mean is, in your documentation, suppose next year intern batch or somebody else in IIT wishes to take this forward, there could be a new set of people who will have to learn everything ab initio. Does your documentation help them in quickly understanding it rather than spending the same time which you all must have?
Actually, we have implemented all the things, so future scope of this project is really less. So if any future intern...
No, I think you are completely mistaken. The future scope is enormous. So consider the following. I don't know whether you have heard of spoken tutorials.
Yeah.
Now, I can easily see spoken tutorial sequence being created for individual labs with actual voice over describing how the experiment is conducted. First making it in English and then translating and dubbing it in multiple Indian languages, because a very large number of students in schools in the country still study in their native language.
Yeah.
So I can see enormous scope. I think it's a very well done work. The only thing is, are you doing the computations online for the result of an experiment? Meaning, can I change the parameters?
Yeah, you can change the
like the volumes or the concentration and so on.
Yeah, yeah, everything.
And you will actually display the correct results.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is the minimum that is expected. Now, this has been done for each and every experiment that you have designed, or only for some?
We have designed 20 experiments, but there is a setup mode in which anyone can set up new experiments if you want. And these are the details he first have to fill, and then there is
You were three people or four people?
We are a team of four people.
Four people.
Yeah.
So was there any sleeping partner, or all four worked?
Well, all three had different job and
No, everybody worked.
Yeah.
There's no sleeping partner in the sense that he enjoyed stay here for two months.
No.
Everybody worked.
Yeah.
Now, has each one would have done some specific work.
Yeah.
But has each member learned what others have done also? Meaning, is there a comprehensive understanding of the totality of the project by every member of the team? That sometimes does not happen. My request to you and request to all of you is, because all of you have worked in teams, and when you are working for a short duration of 2 months, you necessarily distribute work. So if I am assigned some part of the work, I become expert in that work, but I do not necessarily know well what others have done. And same thing about others. So now there is no time, but ensure that after going back or on your way back, you read the entire documentation from the point of view of understanding what others have done better. That will give you a more comprehensive. Just as this session today gives you an exposure to what other teams have done, similarly, you must be completely familiar with whatever your own team has done, all men. But I think it's an absolutely, how many lines of code you would have written approximately?
I have written 35 Java classes and around 12 to 1300 lines of JS code and some 3 JS code.
In two months, there is a lot of productivity. Yeah. All others have also done similar work? Anyway, that's
so we haven't created the matrix.
So you create the matrix and submit it.
Okay.
I'm very proud of what you have done. Even very committed IIT teams would also do approximately this much. Of course, we have group projects in our CS 101 course, and they also do remarkable work, but they are doing multiple courses together and so on. But this is absolutely excellent. Let's give them a big hand. I'm very impressed with you. Thank you. And this documentation, I would like to take it forward with the spoken tutorial team. It has tremendous potential. We can actually provide. So there is one more thing I would like to say, because there are so many simulation, animation projects and so on. So let's understand one thing very clearly. All these animations or simulations or virtual labs are not substitute for actual labs. Actual labs are required because hands-on experience and experimentation is vital for people to understand things. But the time that you require these actual labs for can be drastically reduced if you have animation, simulation and so on. So in this context, I would like to remind you of aircraft flight simulator. You all heard of flight simulator? So can you entrust a person who has been trained only on flight simulator to fly a passenger jet where you are traveling? No, you would be scared, right? So earlier when there were no simulators, the total training time used to be far longer, and it was therefore far costlier, because you need to actually have an aircraft to train a person. Today, the flight simulators permit 80% of the training to be done on simulator, and only 20% of the physical time is required. It is towards this end that we believe that virtual labs, simulated labs, animations, etc. could be useful. They could do two things. One, they could drastically cut down the time required for physical interaction for achieving the same understanding. Second, they can be used as a pre-lab material to a substantial extent to familiarize people with all components, everything, so that when you go to the physical lab, you don't find something completely unknown. These two are very vital, important, training parameters. And it is in this context that we shall be using this training. So, wonderful work. Thank you so much once again.